One of my favorite stories in magic is about a magician named Robert Houdin. Houdin was the magician that Houdini actually took his name from, and he added an I to the end of Houdin, which means like Houdin, and that became Houdini. There was a war between the French and the Marabouts in the 1800s. So he went there with his magic that he was doing and made objects impossible to lift, that he could only lift and nobody else could touch them. One of the Marabouts challenged Robert Houdin to a duel. He said, if you're really a magician, let's see if you can win in a duel. Back to back, they took their steps, they turned around, pointed their pistols at each other, and Robert Houdin just lowered his pistol and let the other guy fire the bullet at him. And Robert Houdin caught the bullet in his teeth. And now he pointed his gun at the man, and then he turned to a whitewashed wall, and he shot the wall. And the wall ruptured and started bleeding. And they believed that he really had powers, and that legendary story is what ended the war. The way that he did that bullet catch is so cool. He made identical bullets out of wax. He says, well, let me make sure the bullets are real. So he pulls the bullets out, does a magician switch, says, okay, they're real. And when they shove the first bullet, the wax one, when he rams it into the guy's gun, he pushes it all the way in so it's gonna basically dissipate on firing. And the other one that was in his gun, he barely pushed it in. So it's when it went out, it would hit the wall and cause the wall to bleed. There was a magician named Chung Ling Su that in 1918 in London was performing the illusion version of the bullet catch, and the gun fired and killed him in front of a live audience. It kind of took a back seat until Annemann, this amazing mentalist, started doing the bullet catch from 1930 until 1942. He would line up lots of people on his left and his right, and he would get a real cop with the real cop's gun to shoot the bullet at him. So he'd line up like this, and Annemann, when he was walking up with the cop, he would say, shoot the bullet a foot to my right or to my left. So the bullet, but when you're on the side, you can't tell if the gun is here, here, or here. And at the moment that the bullet sound went off, Annemann would do a double twist to the ground, and then he'd get up and pull a bullet out of his mouth and survive the bullet catch. There was a magician, I think it was in 1980, named Carl Skeens. And he had a little metal cup that he would put in his mouth, and he would have his wife point the gun at him and fire it, and he'd catch it right in this little cup in his mouth. So he's the only guy that was doing it for real. And he had done it over and over and over. And I was obsessed with this concept. And out of all of the magicians that have died doing the bullet catch, which is about 12 magicians that we know have died doing the bullet catch, he never died, clearly, because he helped me when I did my bullet catch in 2009.